develop a different paradigm. You just do your best, let go and surrender, and then it just happens. I infuse so many experiences in my life and I turn them into an opening, an awakening. So you actually cannot help but fall into the rhythm. You can learn to love yourself. The beginning of my fitness journey, aroga journey, yoga journey, began as a little girl around 12, 13, looking at Shape magazine. I saw the girls on the magazines and I was like, ooh, Tyra, I'm gonna be like that. So I started training with like the football team when I was in high school, and I used to teach actually aerobics to my teachers. I always watched what I ate. Healthiness, fitness, we got carrots, we didn't get Twinkies. So it was instilled in my household. From there, I went on to the modeling career. I was with Elite Worldwide and also with Ford afterwards. 15, 16 years of traveling around the world, modeling, photo shoots, commercials, living in LA, New York, Europe, Africa, literally everything. In the modeling world, I don't think it really pushes towards healthy girls so much. And so I saw a lot of anxiety. Even on my side, a lot of anxiety to be able to fit that size serum, fit that designer label, and I was able to. I worked very hard. I can look at old pictures now and see, wow, I was extremely thin. I needed an outlet, and so I created aroga. Everyone has their mold of what they're allowed to do and what they're certified, that's the best way to put it, they're certified to do. And so I just kind of changed it and decided to be certified in everything, so I can make it my own. I didn't want to just be an aerobics teacher. I didn't want to just be a Pilates teacher. I didn't just want to be a yoga teacher. When I would go to studios and introduce them to kind of a different way, they're like, no, 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 we only teach yoga here. When I opened myself up and take it a little bit more seriously, I started inventing aroga.
I just can't get enough. I just can't get enough. I just can't get enough. I just can't get enough.
Honey, got I took the aspects of aerobics and cardiovascular work and yoga. I needed something quick that would lengthen and stretch and at the same time get my cardio up. And so that was the beginning of aroga, because it's something everyone can do.
But what's so great is the way she uses music is not the way you've seen done in other exercise classes. Every song is taking you on a journey, and that journey is starting out and getting you through the workout.
I really like to sweat, and I like to get my heart rate up, so then I took it private and it is exploded. I can take a client and do whatever I want with them, and they get to grow in their practice, because I have clients that like Pilates, they like aroga, they want it all. And so I created aroga to kind of have your cake and eat it too.
It's changed my approach to working out, to fitness, to meditation, to diet, because you see the possibilities of what your body can do.
You know it's good for you. You see that you're enjoying it, and I think that is monumental in my life.
I guess at the end of the day, I would say aroga for me is empowering. In a real life, fitness, body, wellness way, it's real. Aroga is real.
My personal fitness, and it's not just yoga. That's the beauty of it. It isn't just yoga. That's not what we're trying to accomplish here. It has all the yoga benefits, and that's the beauty of it, but it also has all the aerobic benefits and cardiovascular benefits. There is a complete overall mind, body, and spirit connection. You really can't go into the practice of aroga without feeling something. You are pushed within you. Aroga is really able to change people completely. You start to fall into the rhythm, because aroga is a rhythm of life. It's a rhythm of your breath. Just give it one time and it will change you. I've been praying for the people to say that.